Well, there you have it. Both fighters have had their say.
Okay, well, as you heard everybody speak, and the master of ceremony, so to speak, for Mayweather Promotions, Leonard Ellerbe, announced that that concludes the press conference. We heard from everybody, pretty much everybody on stage, except for Floyd Sr. And Michael Kons, who is part of Team Pacquiao. Ronnie, your thoughts on some of the more emotional, some of the more interesting statements from the respective gentlemen who were on stage, and everybody was a part of the team that made this whole fight possible.
I think it is a very amiable atmosphere.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody was nice to each other, which was a good thing to see, because normally you'd expect in a fight of this magnitude, trash talk and
take some jabs, yeah.
Yeah, take some jabs and so on. Bob Arum, I thought, was at his best today. He is an excellent speaker, he's an excellent host, and I thought Bob did a tremendous job today, and his the way he paid tribute to the Filipinos and to Pacquiao, I think that was very touching, because Bob knows our history. Bob knows the history of this country. He has a great affection for the Philippines and Filipinos, and I think he did a tremendous job for all of us. And Manny and Floyd, they were as good as they could ever be.
Mm-hmm.
Humble, simple, they told it like it was, and everybody came together in an unusual display of unity.
Yeah.
In the bar.
Were you surprised with the humility of Floyd?
Yes, I was. I was surprised. But, you know, he's trying to score points.
Okay.
He's taking a beating in the media or the non-carrying out of this fight for so many years.
Mm-hmm.
They blamed him for not having the fight.
Yeah.
They blamed him for being a coward. He's not a coward. I mean, let's get that straight. He's not a coward. But he selected the time because, to him, he thinks this is the best time for him to fight.
He said it. He said it's all about timing. Like
yes,
all
exactly.
The 47 fights that he's fought and won, that this is the best time for this fight.
Yeah. So it's all about timing, and he's very correct. He thinks that Manny is slipping, and he can win this fight.
Mm-hmm.
Manny Pacquiao also believes that he can win this fight. So we have a great situation here where this togetherness is unbelievable. Is unbelievable, considering how much bad blood there has been over the last 4 or 5 years.
Well, we did hear from a lot of people on the stage.
Oh, Justin Bieber.
Is that Justin Bieber?
Justin
Bieber. Cowboy hat?
Yeah. What's he doing there?
I have no idea. Maybe he just jumps on the stage and nobody can stop him because he's Justin Bieber. But anyway, all right. Different people spoke. Richard Sturm of MGM spoke, and he talked about the history of this fight and the history of what it's going to be in Las Vegas and how the fight is. We do get it. All right. We want to talk about the choice of MGM, the choice of you obviously said Las Vegas. This is what Floyd do always like, but in particular about MGM and the history of fights in MGM.
Well, it's been good to both fighters, both to Floyd Mayweather and to Manny Pacquiao. Manny loves to fight in the MGM Grand also. So it's an excellent venue. It's a nice venue. And Floyd feels at home at the MGM Grand. He's won all his fights. Well, he's won all his fights at the MGM Grand, most of them, as long as I can remember. And he's comfortable there. Pacquiao is comfortable there. And they're great hosts, the MGM Grand. They're great hosts. And unless you go out of Las Vegas, and Floyd was willing to go out of Las Vegas, there's no better venue than MGM Grand in Las Vegas.
We also heard from the respective executives from the different networks. And this was a tricky situation as well, because as mentioned, Manny is tied up with HBO, Floyd is tied up with Showtime, which is CBS. Talk about what you know about how this had to play out, and as well how they spoke today in being in unison with one another now of this historic event.
Well, this happened many, many years ago when Mike Tyson fought Lennox Lewis.
Right.
And people said that fight could never be made, but it was made.
Yeah.
And the two networks came together and did a fantastic job. Interestingly, Manny Pacquiao was on the undercard of that fight of Lennox Lewis.
Lennox was the last minute replacement.
Yeah.
Right?
No, he fought Julio.
Okay.
He fought Julio.
Okay, okay.
And knocked him out. In the second
fight that was shown on both networks.
Right.
Okay, yeah.
So that's where he made his name. And I know there was a conflict at one time from, especially from some of the Philippine media, who were blaming Rod Nazario for his earning only $40,000 for that fight. But Rod Nazario argued, the late Rod Nazario, my dear friend, he argued that it's the exposure. This was the biggest fight of that time. And the exposure meant more than the $40,000 to be on that card. So there's history to fall back on, precedence to fall back. But this time, the man who was really responsible was Les Moonves of CBS, the head of CBS, who's a close friend of Bob Arum.
Okay.
And Bob Arum asked him to do the negotiating, which he handled beautifully. Because, you know, there was a six-fight contract with Floyd Mayweather Jr. He's finished four of those six fights, and they've lost money, except in the Canelo Alvarez fight. They've lost money. The Maidana fights didn't bring them any money. So he had some leverage in talking to Mayweather. Come on, we've lost some money. You've got to give us this fight. So that's how he kind of fashioned it out and got Mayweather to agree.
Well, when we heard Manny speak...
Hey, by the way, just a minute, just a thought occurred to me. If Showtime and HBO Sports can get together in the U.S., why can't two networks get together here, Dito sa Pilipinas?
Don't ask me. I have no idea. So they're simulcasting it, Showtime and HBO, buy whatever pay-per-view you choose, who you buy from.
Who knows?
But anyway,
I would love to see that.
That's your perspective.
I would love to see that. Because, you know, if these two networks that have been fighting and competing in the U.S. can come together, why can't you come together with, I don't know, with the other network? That does the fights all the time, come together and put it together.
Well, we'll see. We'll see what plays out.
Call.
I want to keep my job for now, but anyway.
No.
Manny, let's talk about Manny, what he said. You saw Manny speak from the heart.
He always speaks from the heart.
But I don't know if we would have heard him speak this way 5 years ago, if this happened 5 years ago. I mean, with this gratitude and this thankfulness, thanking God for all the blessings and how this has, who he has become.
Yes.
Since then, from nothing to where he is. That was one of the more significant things he said, that he was nothing, now he's someone, and he's someone fighting the best fight in the world.
Yeah, I mean, you know, I had the privilege of covering Manny's fights in all his early years on Blow by Blow, and he has changed dramatically from there. Frankly, TJ, I never thought Manny Pacquiao would be a world champion, because in the early days of his career, I mean, he just had heart, courage, he had power, but he had no finesse whatsoever. That's why I always credit Freddie Roach for making him a boxer fighter.
A boxer, making him a boxer.
He has honed his skills. He's honed his skills like nobody else. And now Pacquiao is at the top of his game, thanks to Freddie Roach.
And Manny noted that he said that since 2001 we've been together, and he said we're the longest running tandem.
Yes. That's true.
It's fascinating to realize that. Well, but before we let you go, one last thing. It was Bob who said that he sees this fight as elevating the sport of boxing. How big is this fight? At this crucial stage of where there's so many other professional sports that are grabbing attention here and there, there's the NBA, there's MMA, there's UFC. How big is this for boxing to bring it back to that level where it was once?
Because there have been questions about boxing as against the MMA and UFC and all of that.
Yeah.
And some of the bad decisions have contributed to that. Some of the mismatches have contributed to that. And this has salvaged the sport once again and brought it up to the level where it belongs. Because you may be fans of US and all the other sports, but I think boxing, the scientific art of self-defense, is, from a purist point of view, one of the nicest sports you can be in.
Well, we are roughly 7 weeks away from the biggest night in boxing and possibly in any professional sport made to. Ronnie, thank you so much for staying up with us. When you arrived, I don't know what to say, if good morning or good evening or...
good night.
A pleasure. Now I can say good night because you got time to rest. And thank you so much. And we'll be speaking to you more in the coming weeks to come, for sure.
Thank you very much, TJ. Thank you.
To all of you out there, thank you so much for joining us as well. This has been ANT's special coverage of the Floyd Mayweather Manny Pacquiao red carpet press conference live from Los Angeles. On behalf of everybody here and from Dan Castillejo as well, reporting live in Los Angeles, I'm TJ Manato. Thanks for watching.
Thank you, Manato. Maganda ka naman ako.